plumberparts.co.uk. Honest reviews and advice.
Hold tight and welcome to today's plumberparts.co.uk video. I am in one of the hottest boiler rooms ever, and it's only what, like mid-April or whatever it is, I don't even know. But it's absolutely roasting in here, and I don't have my t-shirt, my plumberparts t-shirt, so I've got to wear this lovely hoodie. What we're going to be looking at today is how to fit a remote expansion vessel. And a few of you posted to us on Twitter and Facebook, you've seen a video by another guy on YouTube on how to fit one of these, and you said it was awful. I don't know who it was or anything, but you asked me whether I could do one for you. So we've got a quick job here today. It's a large heating system, so we've got a 25 litre expansion vessel going in. It's a system boiler with the expansion vessel in there is gone. We're going to take that old expansion vessel out and bung it, and we're not going to put one in back in the boiler. We're actually just going to put one remote on the system. Now, the first thing you've got to remember is when you're choosing a place to actually put your new expansion vessel, try and put it where it's not going to get in the way too much for a start, because they are pretty big. Always put it in a place where it can't be valved off. It has to be completely open to the boiler and all of the system, okay? And also try and keep it away from two port valves and places like that. Now, as I said, the system we're working on today is quite a large one. We're actually going to be putting in our expansion vessel on the return pipe from the underfloor heating manifold. All you need to do is find the return pipe generally, try and get that near the boiler if you can. This is about a meter and a bit away from the boiler in pipe work. Then we're going to clip it to the wall, and we're basically going to pipe it up, fill the system up and get it going. But before we do that, very quickly, this one here is pre-charged to 1.5 bar, which is what I'm going to leave it at. This one's actually from Screwfix, so mental. If you want one of them, I'll leave a link for you in the description below. So anyway, just watch me do it. There's not going to be a lot of chatting, you know. It's going to be one of them videos, and it's so hot in here. And I've got a bit of indigestion because I stayed up late last night watching the Masters. Anyway, let's go. Hold tight.
This is a three-quarter female fitting to 15 mil compression. That seals that up nicely, so that's all ready to go. This is where I'm actually cutting into the system. So we're going to cut in here, put a little reducer on it. We've got 22 mil T here. We've got reducer going in there, and what we're going to do, clip there, clip, 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 and we're just going to run our pipe up here, along here like that, and here is where we're actually going to be putting in our new expansion vessel.
So let's go.
Whip back and make a day for you. I give you a moment, golden and true.
Hi,
you've been naughty. Oh, well done. Well done, you've eaten all your dinner. Secret to sexy pipe work is mark your clips first, then your pipe work will just sit in them and look amazing. This is pipe number one. Needs a tiny wee little set in the bottom because our cross pipe at the bottom sticks out a wee little bit further than our clips. Tiny little bend on that. Tiny little bend on the end there. Oh my god. That's just amazing. I see a true color shining through. I see a true color. That's why I love you. God, that's beautiful. Oh, look at me.
Don't give up your daytime job, Jimmy.
What's that, mate?
Don't give up your daytime job. The X Factor is not going to happen for you.
That's not very nice. How about that? He doesn't like my singing. That's not fair. Don't give up your day job. Cheers, buddy. Well, I'm sure you guys out there back my vocal skills and talents. So we've got that hung on the wall now. As you can see, I hate those clips. Not a fan, never have been. So anyway, getting piped up here now. Getting there nearly. Your fittings are good old washed down now.
get all that flux off. Tighten up that compression fitting. Don't forget that. God, no. And there we go. Installed onto the system, teed in just here. Clip, little elbow there, another clip, and up into our new expansion vessel. Right, so there we go, we're all done, we're teed in, it was amazing, I'm so happy. I'm about to fill the system up now. I'm going to fill it up cold to 1 bar, and then we're going to turn everything on and watch it rise up to 1.5 bar, and then just sit there as it expands into this new expansion vessel. Obviously, this is not a description about how pressurised systems work or how you should fill and commission them. This is just purely about how to physically install a remote expansion vessel on the system. You shouldn't really attempt to do anything like this if you don't have a clue about what you're doing. This is more technical than most standard plumbing tasks, I guess, because you know you need to have a good knowledge of pressurised heating systems, and also you need a ticket to be able to do that. But if you do need any more help or any more information, go to plumberparts.co.uk. We're also setting up a deals page there at the moment. It's going along now at the moment. There's a lot of data entry we've got to do, so it takes a little bit of a while. And also we've got to find the deals for you. So keep an eye out on that because it might be handy. Remember, you can follow us on Twitter and Facebook. Just click on the two icons that are appearing now. And also you can subscribe to our videos by clicking on the icon in the corner. See you guys soon. It's going to be mental. The next video, we've got videos coming up on automatic air vents, power flushing, how central heating circulator pumps work. We're going to be cutting stuff in half. Also, I'm going to do a really basic video as well of when you open up a drain off and nothing comes out, what do you do? Because loads of people keep asking us, if I open my drain off, nothing's come out. What do I do? What do I do? What do I do? So we're going to tell you how to do that as well. So anyway, see you all very soon, people. And remember, just, right, I tell you what, I want you to tell me how I should end the video next week. What saying, hold tight, holler, make one up, tell me, I don't know. Anyway, see you soon, people, and remember, hold tight.
Plumberparts.co.uk. Honest reviews and advice.